welcome to this video session. I remain Samuel Chukwu Emeka, aka Sam Dum for Peace. In this video session, we shall continue our study on differential calculus. Please, before you begin this video, it is highly recommended that you view the videos in order. The playlist on differential calculus, it is highly recommended that you view it in order. In this session, we shall discuss sum and difference rule. It is also important that you know power rule prior to this. So please, view the topics in that playlist in order. The playlist is on my website. From what we have done so far, because we are going to use our experience, what we have done on power rule, we are going to use it in the sum and difference rule. So, say we have three functions of x, y equal to u plus v, okay, in this case, and in another case, y equal to u minus v. So, where y is a function of x, u is a function of x, and v is a function of x. Okay? When we talk of sum rule, we see that dy dx, dy dx will be du dx plus dv dx. That is sum rule. So you have the plus in the function. When you are finding the derivative, you have to still put that plus. Okay, whatever happens later on, you now do it, you know, you now solve it. But you still have to put that sign first, and then you now find the derivative. Sometimes the signs might, you might have two positive and negative, and then you just solve it. But you have to still, because of this plus sign, you still have to put the plus in the first step when finding the derivative. Okay? Some textbooks might still say y prime equal to u prime plus v prime. Then here, of course, when we have the difference rule, we have that dy dx, because we have a minus sign in the function, we still have the first step in the derivative of the function, we will still put the minus sign. Okay? Yeah. Or you could say y prime equal to u prime minus v prime. So that is your sum rule. We shall solve several questions today, and I'm going to break it down so that you will understand it. Please, it is important that you know how to solve this, because by the time we do product rule, chain rule, quotient rule, I expect you to have mastered these basics. Okay? So let's get started with solving. Question one. I have the questions here. You have that f of x is equal to 9x exponent 0.5 plus 2x exponent negative 0.5. Okay? So f prime of x will be, this will be 0.5 times 9 times x, 0.5 minus 1, see that, plus negative 0.5, this plus is this plus right here, okay, this plus right here is this plus right here, so you still keep it, you have to still keep it, then negative 0.5 times 2 times x, negative 0.5 minus 1, so this will now be 9 times 5 is 45, 4.5 x negative 0.5, right?
0.5 minus 1 is negative 0.5.
Then plus, this plus is still this plus. 2 times 0.5 is 1. So minus 1x, negative 1.5. So you now, if you stop here, I will take away points. I will take points off. You will still have to remember your rules of algebra. Plus, minus. Minus, plus. Okay? Plus, minus. Plus, plus. Minus, plus. Minus, minus. Okay? Plus, log. Or let me say like. Like. And minus, dislike. When you like to like someone, that means you like the person. I love you. I love you. Hello. When you love to love someone, that means you love the person. So this is plus. Then when you dislike, I don't want to use hate. You know, in this world, we are not supposed to hate. So let me just use dislike. Because I know, in this world, I mean, everybody will not like you. If everybody likes you, there is a problem. If everybody dislikes you, that is a bigger problem. So let me just use dislike instead of hate. We are not supposed to hate, you know. Okay, so if you like to dislike someone, that means you dislike the person. If you dislike to like someone, that means you dislike the person. And when you dislike to dislike someone, that means you love the person. Okay? When it's same signs, it's plus. When it's different signs, it's minus. You learn this in your basic algebra. So if you leave your answer like this, I will take away points. I will. So you have to finish it. 4.5 x negative 0.5 minus x negative 1.5. And because they left it in exponent form, you leave it like this. You leave it like that. Okay? Does that make sense? Alright, let's do number two. Number two, we have 2 over x minus 2 over x cubed plus 1 over x form. H of x is question 2. 2 over x minus 2 over x cubed plus 1 over x form. Find the h dx. The h dx. Okay? So, find the h dx. Find the h dx. So, let's say that this is h of x equal to 2x negative 1 minus 2x negative 3 plus 1x negative 4. So the h dx will be negative 1 times 2x negative 1 minus 1. Okay, you see what I'm doing. I am now, because when you master power rule, I don't need to, you will begin to speed up. You need to speed up. Okay? By the time we go into product rule, chain rule, quotient rule, I expect you to have known these basics. So, master power rule, and then, you know, we need to speed up. Negative 1 times 2x, negative 1 minus 1. Then minus 3 times 2x, minus 3 minus 1. Okay, this minus is this minus. Done. Mess up your minus. See, I use red to do that. Minus is this minus. This minus is this minus. Then minus 3 times 2x minus 3 minus 1 plus this plus here is this plus. So don't mess it up. Because some people mess up with the signs, and you mess it up, it's gone. Then minus 4 times 1 x minus 4 minus 1. Okay, so this will be minus 1 times 2 minus 2 x minus 2. You can just do minus minus plus 6x minus 4, okay, plus minus minus 4x minus 5. See that? So this is minus 2 over x squared. You leave it in that form, plus 6 over x4 minus 4 over x5. Okay? You just, if you think I am skipping steps, do it your own way, but speed up, you know, and don't make mistakes. You speed up a little bit and don't make mistakes. So don't mess up your signs, because students, that is where they come. They might forget to put this minus 3 here. Remember, when we talked about it, if there is plus in the initial function, in the derivative, put that plus before you now solve it in the next step. Okay? You got it? Any question? Now, the next one, number 3. Number 3, we have s of x, square root of x, plus 7 over square root of x. Okay, this is s, so let me just use p. P of x equal to square root of x plus 7 over square root of x. Okay, find p prime of x. P prime of x, but first of all, before we find p prime of x, let's arrange this. So P of x will be x half plus 7 over x half. P of x will be x half plus 7x negative half. Okay? Radicals. Exponents and radicals. So P prime of x will be 1 half times x, 1 half minus 1, plus this plus here is this plus here, folks. Okay? Plus minus half times 7x minus half minus 1. So, just note that. So, p prime of x will be 1 half x, half minus 1 is minus half. Then, plus minus, just do plus minus is minus right away. Okay? Plus minus is minus. 7 over 2 x minus 3 over 2, because minus 1 half minus 1 is minus 3 over 2. Okay, so let's put it back in this form. Let's put it back in that form. P prime of x will be 1 over 2 times, of course, 1 over 2 times 1 over x half, minus 7 over 2 times 1 over x 3 over 2. Okay, see that? So this will be 1 over 2 root x minus 7 over 2 root x all cube. Or you can also write it this way, 1 over 2 root x minus 7 over 2 root x cube. Either of this is okay. Okay? We talked about this in power rule. We talked about this in power rule. Alright, question 4 is next. We talked about it in power rule. And sometimes, if you wanna, you can simplify that. Sometimes you can simplify this. You can simplify this further, okay? 1 over 2 root x minus 1 over, minus 7 over 2, 7 over 2 root x times x squared. If you're simplifying radicals, okay, root x cubed could be root x squared times x, which is square root of x squared times square root of x, which is x root x. So you could do this as 1 over minus 7 over 2x square root of x. You could still simplify it to the least. You could do that. I will take any of them, any of the three, I will take it. Okay? Question 4. Y equal to 7x negative 1. 7x negative 1 minus 4x minus 10. Minus 4x minus 10. So y dx will be negative 1 times 7x negative 1 negative 1 minus 4x minus 4 plus 0. Remember, I want you to master this by now. Okay. We talked about this in the power rule. So this will just be minus 7x minus 2 minus 4. Okay? And we just leave it like that. We leave it like that. We talked about this in the power rule. So please look at that video in the power rule. It is very important. Question 5. G of x equal to 3x exponent negative 1 plus 4x exponent negative 2. So g prime of x will be minus 1 times 3x minus 1 minus 1 plus, this plus is this plus, okay? Just like this minus here is this minus, this plus is this plus. So I want you to just make sure you do not skip it in the first step. In the first step, do not skip it. Plus negative 2 times 4x minus 2 minus 1. So this will give you minus 3x minus 2 plus minus is minus. Minus 8x minus 3. They gave it to you in this form. You leave it like that. You leave it in that form. Any form they gave it, they give you, leave it in that form. Okay? Any form they give you, leave it in that form. Minus 8x minus 2. Question 6 is the next one. So, I want you to practice this and master it. Because as we go further, I probably will skip more steps because I expect you to have known it. Okay? To save time. Question 6. But I'm not going to get you lost, no. Just follow the videos in order like I do it. And you shall not get lost. If you get lost, yeah! Mr. C, come back! And I will come back and get you. Okay, question 6. F of x is 2x cubed minus 3x squared plus x. F of x is 2x cubed minus 3x squared plus x. Okay, so f prime of x will be 3 times 2, 3 times 2x, 3 minus 1, minus 2 times 3x, 2 minus 1, plus 1. Because this is 1x. Okay, we talked about it in the previous video. So this is 6x squared minus 6x plus 1. 6x squared minus 6x plus 1. Okay? So this minus is this minus, this plus is this plus. After you master it, after you master this part, some of you will just look at it and say the answer. Like, I can do that, you know, but I want to take it slow. Okay? But I can just look at it and say the answer right away. Practice makes perfect. Practice. Practice. Question 7, we are getting there. S of x, let me use g of x here. g of x equal to x squared minus 1 over x. I have not taught you product rule. And you can do this by product rule. So, when we do product rule, then we do it both ways. Okay? We will still do it. I'm going to check this particular question. So, as we are doing sum rule and difference rule now, make note of this question, that we shall do this particular question again using product rule, and we will get the same answer. Okay, so take note of this particular question because we shall still do product rule with it. But right now, let us use difference rule to do it. So we have to expand. If you expand that, you have x cubed minus x times, of course, this is, if I show my work, this is like this. Excuse me. X times x squared minus x times 1 over x. If I'm expanding it. So this will be x cubed minus, minus 1. Okay? X cubed minus 1. So g of x is x cubed minus 1. So g prime of x will be 3 times x, 3 minus 1, plus 0, minus 0. Okay, you can say minus 0. Because differentiation of any constant is 0. We talked about that in the power rule video. So this is just what? G prime of x is 3x squared. Take note of this. We will do product rule and we shall still solve this. Okay? Using product rule. Question 8. We are coming there. F of x is 9x4. Come on, this one. F of x is 9x4. So f prime of x will be what? F prime of x is what? What will it be? I mean, 4 times 9x, 4 minus 1. This is 4 times 9, 36x cubed. 36x cubed. Question 9. Yeah, that is power rule. That one is power rule. Question 9 is d over dx. Because you can still get this like this. Find d over dx. And you have 3x4 plus 6x cubed minus 4. 3x4 plus 6x cubed minus 4. So you can, this is like, I mean, this is still finding the derivative. Okay? It is still finding the derivative. Whereby they didn't put the y. This means that y is this function. This means that y is 3x4 plus 6x cubed minus 4. And they want you to find the y dx. That is what it means. Okay, but they just wrote it like this, so that's fine. It is still the same thing. So this will be 4 times 3x, 4 minus 1, plus 3 times 6x, 3 minus 1, then minus 0, because differentiation of any constant is 0. So this will be 12x cubed plus 18x squared. Next one, question 11. I mean, question 10. Sorry, question 10. Y is x 1.8 over 3. X 1.8 over 3 minus x 0.5 over 2 minus x 0.5 over 2. Find y dx. Find dy dx. So let's simplify this first. Y would be 1 over 3 x 1.8 minus 1 over 2 x 0.5. Do you see what I just did now? Let me space it well so that you don't get confused. This is 1 over 3 x 1.8 minus 1 over 2 x 0.5. I am spacing it. I just spaced it so you don't get confused. So folks, how do we solve that? How do we solve it? From here, we see that dy dx will be 1.8 times 1 over 3 x 1.8 minus 1 minus, this minus is that minus, 0.5 times 1 over 2 x 0.5 minus 1. Did you see that? So the y dx or y prime will be at 3 into 1 is 0, 18 is 6, 0.6 x 0.8, because 1.8 minus 1 is 0.8. Then minus 2 into 0 is 0, 2 into 5 is 2, 4, 10, 5. You understand? Do you see the way I did it? So, then x minus 0.5. Okay? And you just, because they gave it to you in this form, you can just leave it in this form if you, you know. Now, if you want to, you could do this. I will take this answer. Okay? But if you want to, you could also have that the y dx is 0.6 x 0.8 minus 0.25 over x 0.5. Does that make sense? And this is still radical x anyway. So I'll take any of this. Okay? I will take it. I just spoke my language now. I will take any of them. Next one is question 11. K equal to 6 over T 1.1. Plus T negative 1.3. Okay. Find the KDT. Find the DKDT. Find the KDT. Okay. So let's express this in an exponent form. This is 6T negative 1.1 plus T negative 1.3. So DKDT will be negative 1.1 times 6 t negative 1.1 minus 1 then plus negative 1.3 times t, negative 1.3 minus 1. See that? So this will give us what? Negative 6.6 t, negative 2.1. Then plus minus is minus. Plus minus is minus 1.3 t, negative 2.3. And then they gave us this as a positive exponent, and they gave us this as a negative exponent. So why don't we just do the same thing for them, right? Let's do the same thing for them. So this will be negative 6.6 over t exponent 2.1, okay, then minus 1.3 t exponent negative 2.3. I will take this. Okay, they gave us one of them as positive exponent and the other one as negative exponent. Now, I will take this. That is fine because you want to give it to them as you saw it. I will also take this anyway. You can also write this negative 6.6 over t exponent 2.1 minus 1.3 over t exponent 2.3. I will also take this, folks. Yeah. But this is the way they want it. Okay? But I'm going to also take that. Alright. The next one is y equal to x minus 5. That one is pretty... you could just call it out. You could just call the answer out. Y equal to x minus 5. Number 12. Y equal to x minus 5. What's the y dx? 1. Just 1. Okay? Y prime is 1. Because this is like saying 1 plus 0. Because that's 1x. Remember, 1x. 1. Then minus 5 plus 1 minus 0. If you want to say 1 minus 0, that's okay. 1x is, the derivative is 1. That's the coefficient in front of the x. Okay, and I demonstrated this in power rule. So please view the video on power rule. Then minus 0. Okay, 1 minus 0 is 1. Next one is, this one is kind of a little bit tricky. D over... just a little bit. D over the t, and you have, just a little bit tricky, a t squared plus b t plus c. A, b, c are constant, okay? A, b, c are constants. Excuse me. So some of you might be asking, okay, these are not numbers, these are variables. And from what I understand in algebra, variables are alphabets, constants are numbers. It's not a fixed rule. It's not a hard and fast rule. It's not a fixed rule. You could still say that A, B, C are constants. And then you treat them like constants as if they were just constants. Okay? So let us find the derivative of this function with respect to t. Let us find the derivative of this function with respect to t. So we just do it the usual way. So this will be 2 times a t, 2 minus 1, plus this t is 1, okay? 1 times b t, 1 minus 1, plus this c. C means C, T, 0. If you want to show all your work, which I am doing now, because some of you might be confused. So I just decided, let me show all my work here. So this same is ct exponent 0. Because anything exponent 0 is 1, remember. Okay? C means like c times 1, which is now c times t exponent 0, which is ct exponent 0. Because we want to find it in t, to show you. So this is 0 times ct 0 minus 1. Just to show you, c is a constant anyway, so you could just say the derivative of any constant is 0. But I am just showing you all my work in case. But you must not, I mean, you could just look at this and say the answer is 2at plus b right away without having to go through all these steps I am going through. So this is 2at, because 2 minus 1 is 1, plus 1 times b is b, t minus t1, t0, okay, plus 0. So this is 2at. 2at plus b, and that's it, because t exponent 0 is 1. Anything exponent 0 is 1. Sum down exponent 0 is 1. Okay, question 14. Question 14. We're almost getting there. Almost getting there. T of x is equal to 6x plus 9x squared over x. T of x is 6x plus 9x squared over x. Okay, folks, I want you to mark this question down. Mark it down again. Mark it down. That's okay. We can solve this question when we do quotient rule. We shall still solve this particular question. Just like I asked you the other time to mark the one for product rule. Okay? So, I have not taught you quotient rule. When we do quotient rule, we shall still solve this by quotient rule. Okay? So, please mark it down. Put asterisks on it. But right now, let us solve it by sum rule. So, let's put this, let's solve it by sum rule. This is 6x over x plus 9x squared over x. So t of x will be x divided by x. It's gone. 6 plus x divided x squared is x. Okay? So 9x. You see that t of x is 6 plus 9x. So t prime of x will be what? 0 plus what? 9. Remember? Which is what? 9. Okay? 0 plus 9, 9. Which is 9. Just take it down. We shall still use quotient rule to solve it. Okay? Question 15. Almost getting there. Almost getting there, bro. Bro, you feel me, bro? You feel me, bro? We almost getting there, bro. We almost getting there, bro. 15, f of x is minus x plus 5 over x plus 1. F of x is minus x plus 5 over x plus 1. Okay, f of x will be minus 1. Well, let's arrange this first, okay? So f of x will be minus x plus 5x minus 1 plus 1. You see that? See what I did? Okay? So f prime of x will be minus 1. I mean, this is minus 1x. So this is minus 1. Plus minus 5, minus 1 times 5x minus 1 minus 1. Then plus 0. Constant. Differentiation of any constant is 0. So this will be minus 1 plus minus is minus. 5x minus 2. This is f prime of x. Do not leave it in this form. Put it back in this form here. So f prime of x will be minus 1 minus 5 over x squared. That's it. Minus 1 minus 5 over x squared. Okay? Question 16. We have 16, 17, 18. Three more to go. 1 over x5 plus 1 over x7. G of x is 1 over x5 plus 1 over x7. So G, that means put it in exponent form. This is x raised to power negative 5 plus x raised to power negative 7. So g prime of x would be minus 5 times x minus 5 minus 1 plus, this plus is this plus, minus 7 times x minus 7 minus 1. And that would be minus 5x minus 6 minus 5 minus 1 is minus 6 plus minus is minus, minus 7x minus 8. Put it back in this form, bro. Put it back in this form, bro. So this will be minus 5 over x6 minus 7 over x8.
That becomes your answer.
So, I mean, practice. Practice, practice. Practice, 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 practice.
Practice, 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 practice.
Number 17. We have fractions remaining. H of x equal to 2 over x squared plus 1 over x cubed. 2 over x squared plus 1 over x cubed. Okay? So H of x will be 2x minus 2, 2x exponent negative 2, plus x exponent negative 3. Now, h prime of x will be minus 2 times 2x minus 2 minus 1 plus minus 3 times x minus 3 minus 1. See what I'm doing? Okay? So this will be minus 4x minus 3. Okay, minus 4x exponent minus 3 plus minus is minus 3x exponent minus 4. And that gives us what? Minus 4 over x cubed minus 3 over x4. See that? Minus 4 over x cubed minus 3 over x4. Okay, the last but not the least. Last but not the least. Question 18. Over x squared, arrow of x equal to 2 over x squared plus 1 over x 2.8. Arrow of x is 2 over x squared plus 1 over x 2.8. Let me make sure. You are 2 over 3x squared, I mean, not x squared. Sure. 2 over 3x squared plus 1 over x exponent 2.8. Okay? So this will be arrow of x equal to 2 over 3 times 1 over x squared. Folks, do you see what I just did now? Kind of different from, slightly different from this we just did. Do you see what I just did now? Because you want to put this in exponent form. I tell you something. Some students, I've seen students do it this way. In the previous classes I've taught in this. They will write 3x. They'll write 3x negative 2. Just like this. Some will now put times like this. So they magically, 3 is in the denominator, and they just magically brought it in the numerator. Magically. Mathematics ain't magic, Let me speak like American. Mathematics ain't magic, ain't magic. Okay? So please, take note of that. So this is 2 over 3 times 1 over x squared plus 1, I can just put this up for x exponent 2.8. Okay? So what I got now, let me finish up this. R of x is 2 over 3 x negative 2. See that? Because this is still times. Plus x negative 2.8. So this gonna be R prime of x now will be negative 2 times 2 over 3 x negative 2 negative 1 plus, this plus is this plus, negative 2.8 times x negative 2.8 minus 1. Okay? So this will now be minus 2 times 2 over 3 is minus 4 over 3 x minus 3. Minus 2 minus 1 is minus 3. Plus minus is minus 2.8 x minus 3.8. See that? So let's finish this up back here. Let's finish question 18 back here. So R prime of x will now be what? R prime of x will now be minus 4 over 3 times 1 over x cubed. I know if I write minus 4 over 3 x cubed, some people might say, what's this guy doing? Okay, so I just want to break it down so you see. Then minus 2.8, okay, times 1 over x, 3.8. See that? Okay? So my final answer, R prime of x will be minus 4 over 3 x cubed minus 2.8 over x plus 2.